Hi everyone and welcome back. In this video, we will try to add one more API and we will try to see how you can access query parameter. Okay, so we have already seen how to access the request parameter and how to do the validation. Like here you can create a DTOs, and similarly we are going to have another APIs where we can have a filter property as a query parameter. So how the URL will be like /API, there you can say filter equal to true, right? Same as we pass username password, filter by equal to username, something like this, where you actually pass the attributes as a query parameter, right? So how can we first pass them, how to validate them, and how to extract the data from that? Okay, so similarly in the query controller we have created another controller as a filter, HTTP get request. Okay, so here instead of body params we have to use query. So what all options you can provide here? You can put a request, response, query, body, param. Here we are talking about query to extract out the query parameter. So this is the query DTO. What I'm expecting that this particular API should have a query parameter filter which is defined. It means that it should be provided, it must be provided, and it must be a boolean, not a simple string. Okay, so in the task controller filter here we are passing query DTO, and then further we can just pass this request param dot filter. It is actually boolean property, so here we can say filter task, new method we can create in the task service. So instead of get all task, we can say filter all task or simple filter task. And then it will further call the store service. We can go to store service and we just add one method, filter task. I mean the sequence flow is symmetric, there is no change. Okay, now filter task is actually will be giving us filter property which will be either true or false. So here we can pass this filter property, and filter property we can just pass to this method filter task. So if you are doing a filtration, right? So I'm just creating a dummy route and all these things, right? So don't take it like I'm writing some code which is actually doing something. Here if filter is not there, if filter is false, then we'll make it true, then we are just returning it. Otherwise if filter is true, right, then what we need to return, we can just filter something, promise.resolve. For now what I will do is I will filter based on duration completed. Okay, let's filter based on name. So we can also run the filter on the name. So this dot tasks dot filter, or you can say a sort. So sort function takes two arguments. I mean simple, this won't work I think. A task and B task, and I'm just running a filter on that. So why it okay, so we just need to do the precondition check. So it is like we are applying sort on the two objects, right? So A dot name, oh sorry, A dot name minus B dot name. Still, so we have to specify that A is of type task and B is also of type task. Okay, the left end of arithmetic operation must be of type any number or begin. So here we are actually trying to sort based on task, so we can actually change this approach a little bit. So first we will do, simply we can do a filter, and filter here, filter is of type task. I mean, it's a good practice to, and here what you can do is you can return only those tasks where I dot, you can say I dot duration is greater than 0. For now, let's keep it as filter. Simple filter. Sorting can also be done on the object properties. Here, like, we can do a sorting on the name property which we have. Why it is complaining? Okay, we can write this in a simple one line. Yeah, this is fine now. So we are doing filter task, and this is how we are passing the filter property. Task params dot filter, same property we are passing. Now we can just try to test this. So we just need to pass the filter property on the route parameter as a query parameter like this. If we are trying to pass it something like this, it's HTTP GET, right? ID must be UUID. Okay, let's see our route. In the task controller, we have filter. So here you will get confused with these two routes, right? Now our controller get confused with these two particular routes. Okay, what we are trying to achieve, right? So we have a GET already ID and we are passing filter, so it will be expecting that, are you trying to pass filter as ID? So it will get confused. So let's try to make it before this. Or we can just change the route because both routes look same. So it will try to consider this filter string as an ID. So to fix this, either we can change the filter URL, I mean the route URL, filter data, I mean I just changed the URL itself, so we'll not get conflicts. Filter data, and based on that, we'll try to say this, task filter and then data we have. Okay, here filter must be a boolean value, right? So if I just try to pass false, this is fine. Filter must be a boolean value. Okay, it is still complaining. Let's see what we have written in the DTO. Query param DTO here, filter is of type boolean, is boolean is defined. Two things we are doing here. Okay, I think what is happening is it is considering this as a string and then it is not able to parse it because we are considering this as a boolean. So here we can just use query parameter, and here you can just pass filter, and you can use parse boolean. Parse boolean pipe, I think this should suffice our condition. I mean, these are different conditions you can think of. Filter parameter, now filter is being passed as this is fine now. Filteration is false. So we can create some data for now. And then we can do get by passing this filter property. Here you can see we are getting that. So this is how the different possible ways, right? Here we are using the validation pipe and boolean pipe, so it get confused. Earlier it was expecting that as a string, so we have to explicitly parse it as a parse boolean pipe, otherwise it will break. Okay, so this is how we can do. I mean, we can also improve this particular bit in the next video, how we can actually put a particular validation pipe.